Hello, I'm Jamie from Shamrocker World, and today I'm going to show you how you can grow starfruits from seeds. Starfruit is easy to grow from seeds, and after several years and with proper care, you can have an attractive and potentially prolific starfruit tree of your own. But before we start, make sure to like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell to see more videos about exotic fruits and how to grow them from seeds. First, you'll extract the seeds from the fresh fruit. You can find fresh fruit during the spring through fall seasons, depending on your regional location. You can find the fruit at local or Asian markets and grocery stores. Make sure to select ripe fruit that is yellow or orange. Do not slice the fruit vertically, as if trying to get the fruit's signature star shape. The seeds are tucked in the center core along the length of the fruit. Remove the light brown, oval-shaped seeds from the core. You can run your finger along the center of the points. Each fruit may have between 0 to 20 seeds, depending on the variety and size. You can still cut the fruit to get the fruit star shape. Just make sure to stop cutting before you get to the brown seeds and pull the seeds out. Rinse off and remove any flesh or membranes from the seeds. Cleaning the seeds will improve germination and will prevent the soil from getting moldy. Prepare to plant the seeds immediately after extracting them from the fruit, or store them in water until you plant them. The seeds will lose viability over time and if they dry out. Avoid refrigerating the fruits for too long because it may affect the seeds' germination rate. I had seeds from fruit that was refrigerated or partially frozen for a few weeks that didn't germinate well. It's best to keep the fruit at room temperature if you intend to grow the seeds. Next, you can plant the seeds. Plant the seeds in a medium depth container and use well-draining soil such as seed starter mix, peat moss, or potting soil. Plant the seeds on the soil's surface and spread them out evenly. It doesn't matter how the seeds lay in the soil. Next, bury the seeds about 3/4 to 1 inch below the soil. Lightly water the container. You can put the container in a plastic dome, cover, or bag to trap in the moisture. Finally, place the container in a warm location, such as a sunny window with indirect sunlight, a greenhouse, or on a plant heating pad. I started my seeds in a winter greenhouse on February 16, 2020. Now you can watch for growth. Watch for sprouting in 1 to 2 weeks. It may take up to 4 weeks to see sprouting. As the seedlings emerge from the soil, they will develop a stem with small, angular, compound leaves. Make sure to keep the seedlings warm and don't let the soil dry out. As the seedlings grow taller, slowly introduce them to indirect sunlight. After several months, you can transplant them into deeper containers, especially if the seedlings are sharing a pot. For example, I transplanted my seedlings when they were 4.5 months old using the available containers. I moved them to a large table to receive a little bit more sunlight. Make sure to watch the seedlings and make sure that they're not getting too hot. The leaves may close or point down if it's getting too much sunlight. 2 months later, I transplanted the seedlings again into a single large container since they grew more leaves and small branches over the warm summer. Also, as the seedlings get taller and have more leaves, you can give them fertilizer such as citrus or fruit tree fertilizer. I gave my seedlings some slow-release granular fertilizer in the late summer, and the seedlings and my other small fruit trees loved the fertilizer. Starfruits grow best in U.S. hardiness zones 9 through 11. It's possible to grow starfruit trees in a container, such as in my area of U.S. hardiness zone 8B. They would need regular watering, but do not like to have wet feet. So make sure that the soil and container are well draining. The older trees will tolerate and prefer full sun. If you live in cold-prone areas, you must protect the young seedlings and trees from cold or freezing weather by growing them in a greenhouse, covering them, or bringing them inside on cold nights. Mature starfruits can handle brief periods of freezing temperatures. The seedlings may get damaged after prolonged freeze exposure. My seedlings showed damage after a Texas statewide freeze event in February 2021. The seedlings didn't show any damage at first, but as the weeks passed, the plant's leaves started to change color and fall off. Many of the seedlings' tops died, and I was afraid that the rest of the seedlings would die too. When I took the seedlings out of the greenhouse in mid-April, over 2 months after the freeze, they still looked terrible. But I kept the seedlings in partial sun and ensured that they got enough rainwater from the rainy April month. I also gave the plants a little bit of fertilizer when I noticed that they were trying to grow back. By the end of May, through another rainy month in the Texas spring, the seedlings bounced back. Leaves and branches started to regrow on the middle and bottom parts of the stem. They looked well enough to receive a transplant. I put the plants back in partial sun while they continued to grow and recover. Starfruit trees may take 3 to 6 years or more to bear fruit from seed than a grafted or air-layered starfruit tree. The fruit from a seed-started tree may not be the same as the original fruit, but starfruit trees can be prolific producers. The trees will produce small, fragrant, pink to purple flowers, and if you live in hot tropical regions, the tree may flower and fruit year-round. As the fruits grow on the tree, you'll want to protect them from pests such as insects, birds, and rodents by covering the tree or fruit in netting or bagging the fruits with mesh bags. Depending on your preference or the star fruit variety, you can harvest the fruit when they are green for tart fruit or wait until they are yellow or orange for sweeter fruit. Star fruits are easy to grow from seeds, and pretty soon you may have an attractive tree that may develop the juicy and crunchy fruits after several years. If you want to learn more about the starfruit, check out my video in the description. I plan to make a follow-up video of the starfruit seedlings as they grow into spring through fall 2021 after their freeze recovery. I'll also follow the new March 2021 batch as they grow a year behind the featured starfruit seedlings. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell for more videos about exotic fruits, growing exotic fruits, gardening, outdoor crafts, and more. Thank you.